A hot topic of controversy lately has been sugar in our diets. There's a lot of information out there, and I wanted to take you through my previous year of eating sugar and give you the results. I did not initially go into this past year with the intent of eating 100 grams of sugar every single day, but after looking at my own personal data, these are the results that I had. So let's get into it. The first thing that I wanted to bring up was my overall weight throughout the course of the year. Months, starting in December of 2017 through August and September, October and November of 2018, I got down to a low body weight of 166 pounds, which is a 28 pound loss when it comes to overall body weight. Up next, I wanted to look at my overall sugar intake per day. And as you can see, based off of this chart, I ate a lot of sugar. And once again, I did not go into my diet with the intent of eating sugar in this quantity, over 100 grams average per day. It just so happened to be this way. So if we look at this chart a little bit closer, we'll see that my average was about 114 grams per day. At the start of my diet, it was more towards 120, and then at the end, it ended up getting down to 125. Yes, I will admit that it did dip down more towards April and May, and I dipped under to about 110 grams per day. But as you can see, later on in my diet, my actual sugar intake increased, but my weight continued to decrease. Up next, a very important one to look at is the total amount of calories that I consumed every single day from December through November. And as you can see, my rough starting calories were at 3,500 calories per day. And over the course of the many months that came, you can see that my calories slowly walked down. They ended up coming down to about 2,500 calories towards the end of my diet. And that is a big thing that I wanted to point out. And as you could see, my calories did get an upswing towards the end, but my weight still remained down. Another very important chart that I wanted to bring up was my total sugar intake in regards to my total calories consumed. So as you can see, based off of this chart, my total calories were roughly 15% sugar. And that may be kind of a lot, and I admit I had no idea that it was about 15% average. But as you can see, my total calorie consumption was about 15% sugar for the entirety of my prep. So when I lost those 28 pounds, it was over the course of, you know, 9-10 months, and my sugar intake remained exactly the same. So although my calories did come down, and although my carbohydrates did come down, which we'll review next, my total sugar intake remained the same throughout the entirety of my whole diet. And like I just said, my carb intake did decrease over time. And one thing I wanted to point out was that I started roughly at about 420 grams of carbs per day. And then as you could see over the course of my diet over the many months, they got down to about 250 grams of carbs per day. So a significant decrease over time. But as you can also see, when my carbohydrates did drop, towards the end, I did start bringing my food back up and my weight continued to drop. So now let's look at all the charts together to help paint a better picture. As we can see, my weight took a plummet. I lost 28 pounds. As I decreased weight, my calories decreased at the same time. My sugar intake remained exactly the same in regards to the percentage. The amount of sugar I consumed per day, once again, remained fairly steady throughout the entirety of my prep, averaged over 100 grams a day, and my weight continued to drop even though I was eating sugar. My calories did drop accordingly too, along with the carbohydrates, because obviously when I'm going to lose weight, I wanna make sure that I'm in a caloric deficit. Why I'm bringing all this up, because recently there was on the Joe Rogan podcast, two guys that were arguing back and forth, debating whether you could lose weight while eating sugar. Not necessarily on the pro sugar side, but he was arguing about why calories matter was Stefan Guiene. And on the opposing side was Gary Tobbs. And Gary was essentially saying that it doesn't matter how many calories you are eating per day. If you're eating sugar, you cannot lose weight. So in this video, I wanted to break down my own experience with eating over 100 grams of sugar every single day and prove to you guys that you can still eat sugar and lose weight. And yes, I ate an exorbitant amount of sugar. I will be the first one to admit that. I probably shouldn't have eaten 100 grams plus of sugar every single day, but it just goes to show you that you can eat sugar in moderation and still lose weight while keeping your calories under control. Now, how did we get here? How did we get to the sugar is the devil? In the late 70s, there was a craze of the low-fat foods, and this led to people removing fat from any foods. But when you remove the fat from foods, they end up tasting like cardboard. So in order to make the foods taste better, you have to add things like sweeteners, aka sugar, to them to make them taste better. So people were eating lots more sugar, and they were eating less fat. So people thought that if you ate fat, you would get fat. So they took the fat out of their diets and replaced it with sugar. Over the course of the past 50 years, we've definitely been eating more sugar, but there's actually been a slight downturn in our sugar consumption over the past, I would say, 5 to 10 years, because people are getting a little bit more informed. They're understanding that sugar probably isn't the best thing for you, especially refined sugar, mainly because, you know, it's not satiating, meaning that it doesn't keep you full, and it's an empty calorie. You know, we're getting calories in, but they're not necessarily doing much for us. I'm sure if you're out there and you've eaten, you know, a candy before or a donut, something along those lines that's high in sugar, it doesn't necessarily satiate you as much as an entire meal would. So refined sugar isn't necessarily doing anything for us when it comes to feeding our bodies and keeping us fueled. And of course, I probably don't need to bring this up, but obviously the obesity rates have increased over the past few decades. And that's a national plague going on right now. And I wanted to cover this briefly as well in this video, because I want to draw some conclusions on why I think the obesity rate is going up so high. So if we look at this graph, you can see that the obesity rate from 1980 to 2010 has increased from about 17% all the way up to, let's say, 37% where it sits currently. If you go to 1980, we'll call that roughly 3,000 calories today, comparing that to back then, comparing to now, we have 3,682 calories in 2013. If you go to that increase, you actually find out that it's a 22% increase from calories consumed in 1980 to 2013. If you look at the same chart that I just went to before, and you look at the increase in obesity from 1980 to 2013, you're gonna see that it's a 19% increase. So 19% obesity increase versus a 22.73 calorie increase. And those go hand in hand, because as we start to raise calories, overall, people are gonna get fatter, and that's how people enter the obese category. During that same time, people's jobs started to get less physical. So in this chart, you can see from roughly 1980 to 2010, and overall from 1960 to 2010, there's a definite downward trend in your average energy expenditure that you burn at work, your average calories that you're burning at your job. Why? Because the computer age happened, a lot of us more have desk jobs. So at work, we're just burning more calories. Obviously, that's 8 to 10 hours a day. A lot of us are working and we have more sedentary jobs, so we're burning less calories. This chart shows a reduction in energy levels throughout the workplace. So it shows that light activity has increased, moderate activity has definitely decreased, and the sedentary lifestyle, the sedentary jobs have increased in the workplace. Now, this one did surprise me, I will admit, and I didn't believe it at first, but this is the percent of adults 18 years or older reporting no physical activity in their leisure time. So that has actually gone down since the mid-1990s. At one point, it was at 40%, and now it's roughly at 27%. So that's a definite decrease, and I did not believe this for sure. I thought people were getting less physical activity, but it actually shows that they're getting a little bit more physical activity. One other reason why I think people are getting fatter is because we can get groceries delivered to our door. We can get any restaurant that we want with the push of a button on our phones to get delivered to our door. We don't even have to go out for it anymore. We don't even have to walk to get it delivered to us. Any food that we want from any restaurant in the area. So I think now, and especially today's modern time when we have grocery stores full of abundance and we can just go and we can pick things off the shelf, that just gives us a tremendous access to fattier foods. And I think people are just eating more foods because they're more readily available. Another reason why I think people are getting fatter too is along the same lines, people are just cooking less. And over time, you know, back in the 80s and the 60s, 60s, 70s, 80s, people were doing a lot more home cooking. We are just less informed today of what's in our food, and because we go to restaurants, we just bring things off the shelf that are pre-made, and it's just for convenience. So we all know, and I'm guilty of it myself, we're all about the convenience factor these days. So would we rather sit at home and try to cook dinner for an hour, or would we rather, you know, have something pre-made and it's ready in 2 to 3 minutes because we heat it up in the microwave? Because of that change, we become way less informed on what we're actually putting in our bodies. And I think the obesity crisis could actually be solved if people just started cooking all their meals at home and actually making them. Because if you're physically making your meal, you're not gonna be putting pounds and pounds of sugar or olive oil or copious amounts of carbohydrates in your diet, because you're gonna realize that when you're pouring things in there that, wow, that's actually a lot, so we should probably dial that back. So I'm not here to advocate sugar. You know, like I said before, it's an empty calorie, especially refined sugar, and there's probably some negative health effects on overconsumption of sugar over an extended period of time. But I'm also here to prove that you could lose weight. Like I said, I lost 28 pounds over the course of about 9 to 10 months while eating 114 grams of sugar on average per day. So if somebody's out there and they tell you that calories don't matter, do your research. That's all I have to say, because yes, I understand that I'm one person and, you know, this is just the data from one person. But if we go back and you look at calories and a deficit and capping calories, you'll see that calories really, really are king. So I wanted to show you guys what I looked like on day one of my diet in conclusion, and then show you what I looked on the last day of my diet when I went to prep. And I will say this now, I didn't say this in the video yet, is that I'm a competitive natural pro bodybuilder. So this is what I do for a living. I coach physique athletes and I do contest preps myself. So like I said, I didn't necessarily go into this diet with the with going in to eat 114 grams of sugar per day. It just so happened to be, you know, whatever my diet consisted of, just had added sugar to it. So this is what I look like on the first day. And I'll flip through a couple pictures so you guys can see it yourself. And then this is what I look like after all those months of consuming, and I did the math, it was about 84 pounds of sugar that I ate total from December through November of, you know, 2017 to 2018 respectively. So this is what I look like. And I know that this necessarily isn't the look that a lot of people are going for. And that's quite all right. But the whole point of this video was to show that you can definitely lose a lot of body fat. And yes, I understand that my body fat level got extremely low because, you know, it is an extreme sport and I understand that. But this same principle applies to anybody, whether they're a competitive physique athlete or just a general population person, someone looking to lose 10, 20, 30, 40 pounds. I myself even lost 28 pounds in this entire process. So if I can lose 28 pounds, anybody can lose 28 pounds. Am I saying that you can eat 114 grams of sugar every single day? Am I saying that you could eat 84 pounds of sugar over the course of, you know, 11 months and lose this weight? I'm not saying that it's gonna happen for you because everybody's metabolism different. But I did look up what the average American consumes in sugar, and it's roughly 114 grams of sugar per day. So I'm right on the American average. It just goes to show you that if consumed in moderation, sugar, fat, carbs, protein, whatever, if you cap your calories over time, it's proven that you could lose weight. So guys, hopefully you found this video informative. It's a little bit different style than I'm used to. Hopefully you enjoyed my information from my contest prep. Hopefully it paints a better picture on actually what happens when you consume sugar over an extended period of time. If you have any questions, comments, I'm sure there's gonna be some backlash on there. And I'm ready to take that because this is a touchy subject, and I know that sugar necessarily isn't the best thing out there. And I'm not here to advocate that sugar is awesome. I'm not. But if you can, I'm showing you guys that you can eat sugar and lose weight. Until next time, guys, keep dominating every aspect. I'll see you soon.